Yaskawa.
Welcome to this Yaskawa e-learning video. I'm Paul Avery. This presentation is part of a series of videos demonstrating the ease of integrating Yaskawa variable frequency drives, or VFDs, onto a Rockwell automation PLC using Rockwell software. This presentation will cover where to get the Yaskawa Tag Generator program, how to use it, and how to import the tags it generates into Logix Designer, formerly known as RS Logix 5000. What are tags in the world of PLCs? In the simplest form, tags are used to convert a cryptic variable into something that makes sense to you. To get started, let's download the Yaskawa Tag Generator install file. Go to www.yaskawa.com and hover over the Products menu. Then go down to Industrial AC Drives and select Network Communication Products from the expanded menu. On the Network Communications Protocol page, select the Ethernet IP protocol. Once on the Ethernet IP page, we can find the Tag Generator download link under the Software tab. We will click the link, download the file, and install it. Now that we have acquired the software, we will open the program and start a new project. When we start a new project, a pop-up will ask us which protocol we would like to create tags for. As shown on the pop-up, Yaskawa's Tag Generator can be used to create tags for DeviceNet, Ethernet IP, Profibus, or Profinet. For our demonstration, we want to create tags for an Ethernet IP node, and we will call our project ELV_demo. For this demonstration, we will create tags for an A1000 that we had connected to a Compact Logix PLC in a different ELV about connecting a Yaskawa VFD to an Ethernet IP network using Rockwell software. To start, click Add New Node, and the Add New Node window pops up and asks you which network you will be creating a node for, DeviceNet or Ethernet IP. Select the appropriate protocol and option card for your configuration. In our demonstration, we will select Ethernet IP and the SIEN3D. In order for the tag generator to create the correct associations, you'll need your module properties information from Logix. Select the assemblies that you had chosen. In the other ELV, we use the assembly pair of 2171. Depending on the scope in which you plan on using these tags, you'll need to enter that into the scope field. If you're planning on using the tags globally, delete main program from the field and leave it blank. You'll also need to enter in the node name as it was entered in Logix, which for us is A1000 based on the other ELV. Getting the name exactly the same is very important. There, now our node is created with the proper name and proper tag. If you discover that there was a change to the node name or assemblies being used, you could go back to that specific node and make changes using the Edit Selected Node button. The tag generator also allows you to clone the node you created. This will make it easier for you to replicate nodes if you are using the same configuration for multiple nodes on your PLC. When you choose to clone a new node is created with the same settings, but with new appended to the end of the node name. Enter in the name that you wish to associate this with in Logix. The tag generator also allows the modifying of tag names. On the node setting window, click on the Tags tab. For our demonstration, we will select the Run Forward tag and change it to conveyor_run. Before creating the file that is used to import the tags, you can specify a new location and name to give the import file. In this demonstration, we will change our output file name to elv_demo.csv and build our tag list, noting where it will be saved. Click the Build Tag List button and your import file will be created. If you wish to save this configuration file so that you can revisit this later, click on the Save Project button. It will prompt you just in case you exit without saving, but that will be your only warning. To finish our discussion of the tag generator, we will demonstrate how to import the tags we just created into our target software, Logix Designer. In Logix Designer, click on the Tools menu and select Import, and then Tag and Logix Comments. If Tags and Logix Comments is grayed out, it may be because the software is online with the PLC and won't allow tags to be imported. Fix this by using the Communications menu to go offline, then attempt to import the tags again. If the import is successful, you see the newly imported tags under the controller tags window. Notice how our conveyor run tag is included in the list in place of the run forward tag. Once the tags are imported properly, we can test them by going online and downloading the changes. Once we are online, we can test tags by using them to run the VFD. We'll demonstrate that here by setting the conveyor run to 1 and entering a 45 Hz frequency reference. Then we can verify that our motor indeed responds. I hope you enjoyed this e-learning video. If you found this useful, please check out the other videos in this series: Connecting to Rockwell, Importing and Using Yaskawa Add-on Instructions, or AOIs, and Importing and Using Yaskawa Faceplates. Thank you.